Into our program. It's really a new series, How to Control Your Negative Emotions. And this segment, we shall be talking about doubt. Everybody has self-doubt, and it's crippling, even killing. I want to explore that in every possible detail, and I have the opportunity, since we're doing this every night of the week now, here in Los Angeles at least, to take it easy. And to develop the idea very slowly. The first few half-hour segments, I'm going to explore some theory. It's not theory to me, because it's a fact. But it'll be theory to you, and it'll be mind-blowing to you. It'll be shocking to you. It'll be very disturbing. There's some strange things about self-doubt, because your self-doubt can become a belief. For example, if you believe something, let's say you were Adam in the Garden of Eden, let's make it simple, and God said to you, now don't eat of the fruit, don't eat that, don't ride your bicycle, we'll take a bicycle, don't ride your bicycle today, Adam, because I don't want you to, I know more about danger and about the problems of life and the lurking hidden dangers everywhere than you do. So you just trust your father, just don't ride the bicycle. So a little boy comes along and says, don't listen to your dad. You know, your dad's just testing you. He wants to see if you're a man. You know, he makes a good argument. He's appealing to the concupiscence, that is the rebelliousness, the desire in little Adam, little son of God, to be his own person, his own God. But by the way, that's a belief that everybody feels deep down inside. We all want to be God. And for this reason, it's easy for someone to come along and to cause us to doubt what we know is right in our heart. Because we don't want to owe allegiance to anything greater than ourselves if we want to be that great one ourselves. We want to be above everything and beneath nothing. We don't want to be beneath common sense. We don't owe any duty to what is higher than ourselves. See, if we're going to be that ourselves, we can't be responsible to anything higher than ourselves. We cannot be a servant if we're going to be a king. See, so there's a little psychology, a little thought that goes along with the reasons perhaps why we doubt ourselves. See, because we have something greater in ourselves and we want to be the great. So along comes the little boy and he says, don't listen to your dad. Let's go and have fun. Let's take our motorbikes and go and do our thing. Now, the moment you believe a person and you don't believe yourself, you don't believe what you know you should believe in, the moment you desert your first belief system, your first estate, you're actually believing into what's made you doubt. Is that too fast for you? See? In other words, to believe somebody, you have to doubt yourself. So, this is our problem. If it's true that the human race came into existence because of self-doubt, it seems to me that we would all be born self-doubters. Because once you, little Adam doubted himself, what is the first thing he did? He made an excuse for it. Isn't that what you do when you are made to doubt and go against your own best interests? Don't you make excuses? In other words, you can't admit that you're wrong. In other words, when you become wrong by doubting what is right and believing what you want to believe. But then you doubt that you are wrong. Now you're dependent on both the same types of people to help you believe in yourself. You're afraid not to believe in yourself. Deep down inside us, we're all afraid of not believing in ourselves. We all want to believe in ourselves because deep down inside, right deep in our psyche, as far as you can go, all of our problems, every problem we ever had in our entire existence stems from not believing in ourselves. Believing in what we were born to know, but being seduced by the little boy to go out riding on our motorcycles, or as it was in the Garden of Eden, to eat the forbidden fruit of knowing things for ourselves. But we don't know things for ourselves because we take on the mind of the betrayer. Am I going too fast? I said I'd go slow, but I haven't. Have I gone too fast for anybody? You just, it's pacing it right.